I'm feeling good.
Michael Bublé is the universally loved Canadian crooner.
I'm feeling good.
Who's kept fans cooling their heels for news on new music. Now that wait is over with the announcement of his 11th studio album, Higher. Michael covers the classics like no one else can, delivering his take on some of the greats, like Sir Paul McCartney, Bob Dylan and Willie Nelson, with a new Bublé bop or two thrown in for good measure.
I'll never not love you.
Welcome back to the project, Michael Bublé.
Thank you for having me, Lisa. You're the best, and I appreciate you having me on here.
Well, last time we chatted, I was lucky enough to be serenaded by you, Michael Bublé, so I'm trying to work out how you're going to top that this time.
I'm now going to write a song for you. Are you ready for it?
Yes, please.
It's called Lisa, and it goes like this. Lisa, I love you more than pizza. You're just so lovely in your leopard outfit, and I just love singing songs for you.
Yes, I can see that going to the top of the charts.
I had a little bit of a cold. I know it's not perfect, but it will get there.
I'm sure. I believe. I absolutely believe. Now, I also believe in your new album, Higher, which is on its way. I hear that you've never been more excited. Tell me what makes this one so special.
Honestly, with all the humility I can muster up, it is clearly not just the best record I've ever made, but possibly one of the greatest albums of all time.
Oh, right.
Ever. And I'm talking the Beatles,
yeah,
Stones,
mm-hmm,
Sinatra.
Wow.
Honestly, Lisa, I literally surrounded myself with people that have so much more talent than I do that it was almost impossible for me to mess it up. I was so excited to be able to talk to you and for you to hear it. And you haven't heard it yet, have you? You've heard pieces, little things.
Yeah, we've heard a couple of the singles. We've heard I'll Never Not Love You. Love that.
Yeah.
Is it true that that is a bit of a follow-up to Haven't Met You Yet?
Yeah, you know, I didn't think I meant it to be, but I think it is definitely a sequel. One of those really hopeful songs that, you know, fill you with the hope that you can find the love too.
Well, speaking of gorgeous women, your wife, Luisana. Now, I'm hearing that she has actually completely stolen the show in the video for I'll Never Not Love You. We haven't seen it yet. So can you tell us more? And please feel free to mime.
The video is an extension of my life, which means that whether you watch this music video with us or you have a dinner party at our house, you'll always like her more than me. She's just better than me. And I'm just not even joking. I married up and she is the best thing that ever happened to me.
Well, you have three beautiful kids together. Would you say that she's the boss of the family, Michael?
I'd say she's the matriarch for sure. We've been through a lot too. You find out, Lisa, who people are when the poop hits the fan. And we've lived through that. And I know who my wife is. And she's great. I think she probably would say the same thing about me, I hope.
So your kids are now 8, 6, and 3. Have they worked out that Dad is actually a global superstar yet?
No, because Dad puts on a bat suit and then he does his hair and he puts his wig on and they put the Botox in and the 17-inch lifts and then he goes to work. And now I'm the bum wiper, the story reader in bed, the take them to school, the play hockey with them or play football. And then I put on my suit. You know what's funny? I think they actually, the 8 and 6-year-old right now, I think they actually understand that there's parts of it that aren't attractive for them. My son came home one day and he said to me, Poppy, the kids in school asked if we were rich. He said, what do I say, Poppy, when they ask me? And I said, if they ask you, I said, you tell them that you are rich. And I said, you tell them that you're rich in your faith, in your family, in your friendships. And I said, because rich doesn't mean what you think it does. I said, no, I know a lot of people that have a lot of money. And I said, and they're some of the saddest people I know. So I think we've tried to just be normal and real. And hopefully we just give them an environment where they see it. We don't have to tell them.
I'm sure that they would see that every single day, Michael. Now, the album has a fabulous cover of Sir Paul McCartney's My Valentine, and he actually produces the single as well. Did you have a moment of thinking, I'm actually working with a Beatle?
You know, it's really interesting, and that's a great question. But no, because I didn't ask Paul to produce this record because he was a Beatle. I asked Paul to produce the record because I felt he was what was best for the song. I think he's the greatest musician on the planet. And I think now if people didn't know that, when they watch Get Back, they see it. You know what's funny? Watching him write, you can just see the musicality and the talent. It just pours from every fiber of his. It's in him. It's like God is, you know, shouting out melodies and it's just coming out of him. And it was like that working with him. It was me hoping that he could help for me to mold a story that I knew meant so much to him and his wife. And I'm sure when people ask him what it was like, I know what he's going to say. He's not going to take credit. He's going to say, well, Michael and his arranger, Nicholas Jacobson Larson, did all the thing and I didn't do it, because that's who he is. I mean, 15 years ago, somebody asked him how he felt that people always thought John Lennon was the one who was talented and the one that was doing everything. And he didn't even become defensive. He just said, well, I know the truth. And then 15 years later, we all found the truth. So when you're great, you don't have to tell people.
Yeah. Now, Michael, I've seen a stack of tour dates on your website, but I couldn't quite see Australia there just yet. Please tell me that we're not going to miss out.
You know you couldn't keep me away. Are you kidding me? I can't wait to come and reconnect again. I miss everybody so much. And I have so many great friendships there too.
Well, if that's the case, can I put my hand up and say, please, can we have you back at the project desk?
I would love to come back anytime. I'm yours. As a matter of fact, I would love to see you in May when I am coming for promotion.
Okay, we've got a date right there.
If you'll have me, I would love to be there. I'm there.
Sold to the man with the fiddle leaf in the background. Michael, it is always such a joy to chat to you.
And thank you, Lisa.
Thank you so much for joining us. Look forward to seeing you in May.
Thank you for your time. I can't wait to leave prison. It'll be great.
And his spot is right there. Michael Bublé's new album, Higher, is out March 25th.